Thanks for staying with us. So, last Sunday, residents of Asaba, the Delta State capital, were thrown into confusion following a threat letter issued by suspected jihadists to attack the capital city over Governor Ifeanyi Okowa's support for the ban on open grazing in the southern part of the country. However, police have since dismissed the threat, saying the letter was circulated by miscreants to create fear. Joining us on the show now is the Delta State Commissioner for Information, Charles Aniagwu. Welcome to the show, sir.
Immediate Past Commissioner for Information. Good morning.
All right, sir. Good to have you on the show. So give us an update.
Let me appreciate it.
So give us an update on what's going on in Delta State. So everybody got scared. I mean, over the weekend, when we saw the reports and the letter went circulated all over social media, and everybody was scared about what could happen in Delta State. Could you give us an update on your view, how far the government has done to protect the state, and what, and if we have any reports on where the origin of this letter?
Well, like I rightly corrected, I'm the immediately past Commissioner for Information, but I'm still in Delta and at least in touch with the authorities to have a fair knowledge of what is happening. And of course, like you also rightly mentioned, the threat went viral on the social media, and so even the traditional media also reported it. So to that extent, I also got the same information as to that issue of the threat coming from a group that called its name Fulani Jihadists. I'm aware that the authorities, as the governor, have directed the security agencies to be up and doing, and then the commissioner of police in the state have also issued a statement in that regard. And I'm also very much aware that the Arawa group here in Delta, comprising of also the Hausa and the Fulani, and of course a group of others from the northern part of the country, have also dissociated themselves from that particular threat. Mm-hmm. But given the trend that has happened in other parts of the country, the government is not lying low on these issues. They are dealing with it, but Deltans have also been able to go about their businesses, because why we will not want to, the government may not want to believe that it's coming from those who claim they are Fulani jihadists. The government is not also mindful of the fact that some persons may want to also play some pranks with the view to increasing the level of mistrust that is at the moment prevalent in our country. And here in Delta, the government have urged the citizens to go about their business peacefully, to continue to respect the relationship that have always existed between Deltans and indeed other ethnic groups, whether they are Fulani or whether they are other ethnic groups in the country, because for the past years, Delta has been in the news largely for the good reasons, and the government is very much interested in keeping it at that.
Right.
So the movement for emancipation of the Niger Delta meant, and some other groups have responded this morning. Shouldn't we be careful? You know why I say this? We have a situation now in the southeast beyond our control, and it started from things like this: having letters pasted, mischief makers, you know, posting letters, and then inciting reactions that were beyond control. And today, attack of our police stations, attacks of our INEC offices are happening southeast. And now they've moved to Delta. I personally felt yesterday that these are mischief makers trying to give foundation for whatever crisis they want to start within the state. What exactly do you think about that letter? Do you just accept it as it is? Or is there another way you're seeing it?
Well, what you understand is that oftentimes government and indeed the host number of Nigerians are talking about the need for us to remain one indivisible entity. And personally, I also subscribe to the fact that we need to remain one country, because there are a lot of advantages that will derive from remaining as a country. But from behind, you just see that there's a lot of balkanization of the country. You see different groups now speaking for themselves. And if you ask me, I will blame it on the doorstep of the presidency and indeed the central government. The federal government needs to step up its ass and ensure every Nigerian, irrespective of your ethnic group, that this country belongs to everybody. Now, you mentioned the issue of men responding. Of course, you do expect that it is only an unwise man that you say tell that you are going to kill, and he decides to still stand at the same spot. You do expect that the individuals will reserve the right to continue to protect their territory in the event that the federal government is not able to do what is expected of them in that regard. But we just do hope that the federal government will rise up to the challenge and give every part of this country that particular trust and that particular confidence that we can rely indeed on the federal authorities to protect all of us. Otherwise, you begin to see where states will continue to ask their people to defend themselves. You saw what happened in Zamfara just 2 days ago, where the governor addressed them and asked them to defend their communities. Of course, you know the situation in Benue and a number of other states. So if every state continue to ask their people to defend their communities, then where lies our Nigerianness and our nation? Mm-hmm. And that is why, in Delta, we are quite mindful of the need for us, both at the center and the state level, to continue to promote tendencies that will further unite us. Our people are very mindful of this unity. They have continued to respect different persons irrespective of their ethnic background. And the Arewa's talk acknowledged that in their briefing, that Delta have extended to them a lot of love. And we just do hope that they will continue to reciprocate that, because the love and unity is not in short supply in Delta State.
Right.
So as long as everybody who the state continue along that line, be rest assured that Delta will continue to welcome them and continue to extend that same hands of fellowship and love.
Let me go on a quick break. When we come back, we'll continue this conversation. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Stay tuned. Your View will be right back.
Thanks for staying with us. We still have the former Commissioner for Information Delta State with us, Mr. Charles Aniagwu. Yes, Mariam had a question.
So
go ahead, please.
There are two things that worry me about this, and I just hope you can, you know, help me. So first of all is the almost quick dismissal of these letters as being from mischief makers or from miscreants. And I'm hoping that the state government is putting pressure on the police to find out and fish out who these miscreants are, no matter how tiny or inconsequential they are, because we understand the power of words. Secondly, I would like to understand if you are saying MEND now speaks for the government of Delta State in their response. Is that the response that the state government wants to put out as their own response, given the disassociation of the Arewa and association in Delta State?
Well, let me start from the later part of your question. MEND does not speak for Delta State government, but whether you like it or not, Delta State is occupied by people of different ethnic groups. And then the Niger Delta, where Delta State is also situated, has a lot of different ethnic groups. So if a particular ethnic group feels threatened, and then they believe that the government or a region believe that the government at the center has not done so much, they are not going to likely fold their hands. They are not responding to the government, because don't forget they are not addressing the federal government. MEND is addressing the group. So if a particular group threatens you, assuming that the group is actually genuine, there is nothing that also stops another group to say, no, you cannot threaten me. And that was why I said that it's important for the federal government to come to the center and make every group, irrespective of where they are from, to have that sense of belonging.
Yes.
So if that threat is coming, these police authorities have spoken on behalf of the state authorities. And I also made it very clear that I'm very much aware that the governor had met with the security operatives in the states, and then decisions have been taken as to how to deal with such issues. Of course, you do know that issues of security are not things that you largely come to television and begin to divulge your tactics. I'm quite aware that the government is working out modalities to address such issues, but I'm talking about living tokenism, which is individual states having to put in place their processes of securing their people, to a larger and much more comprehensive approach, which is to come from the federal government, so that every Nigerian will have a sense of belonging. Because if you don't, our talk of oneness, our talk of a greater country, our talk of people not dismembering their country will be in vain. Because once you have individuals protecting themselves and speaking for themselves, and then holding on to their different groups as what gives them sovereignty, then where lies our sovereignty as a nation? That is why I will want to urge the president to please resume duty. I am now quite convinced that the president seems to be off duty. Because if the president is on duty, these individual groups that are threatening at different parts from different parts of the country, and the amount of death that you are seeing is very, very terrible. It's not tolerable anymore. And you may be speaking today, you don't even know what's going to happen tomorrow. Nobody is spared in this whole thing. Even those who think they are very, very comfortable as politicians or who are occupying very high political positions, and they defend what is happening because it suits their pocket today. You need to even be alive to enjoy the content of your pocket.
So,
and that is why it's in the interest of everybody to ask the federal government to take action, and then for us to also support the federal government to do that, so that all of us have this peace that we earnestly yearn for.
Excuse me, you said the president should resume duty. Do you think, are you saying he's off duty?
Very much off duty. You do know, even without me saying it, that the president is off duty. Otherwise, a number of individuals who are progressing in error, both in their comments and in their
actions, in error,
will not, by any stretch of imagination, continue to walk in that direction. Hmm. We need a country that works proud. And once the president lets us know, everybody, look at, for instance, in the eastern part of the country, even in the western part of the country, needn't I also mention the middle belt? Everybody is now more or less restricting themselves or properly reclining to their ethnic groups. Mm. People progressing in that direction cannot, by any stretch of imagination, protect and indeed promote our nationality. I'm a proud Nigerian and I want to remain so. Mm. And I wish and pray that our authorities that have sworn by provision of even to protect us and give strength to provision of Section 14 of the Constitution will do so, because our security will indeed guarantee even the prosperity of our country.
Right.
The way things are happening in this country, it does appear that the president really needs to resume duty.
I agree with you, sir. But the president recently, during an interview, addressed us. So let's just say he came on duty.
So he's out, yes.
And he talked about, you know, grazing reserves, getting the
grazing routes back.
What's it called? The, not a memo. I'm
forgetting. The Gazette.
The Gazette. And reviving the grazing reserves. And, you know, saying he's trying to, you know, revive the grazing routes and saying nomadic lifestyle must continue. I felt, you know, this is not in touch and in tune with what is happening presently, you know, because
that even,
we should be progressing.
That even clearly underlines that for a very long time, the president has been off duty. How can the president be talking about 1903 Gazette at a time like this?
So what would you advise? Yes, let's use this platform.
The last time I appeared on your program, I made it very clear that I am not aware that any time the cattle colonies came together and then made a suggestion that they needed to shed weight, in which case you can make them to trek from Karanamoda to Bayelsa so that they can afford to shed weight like an individual who wants to embark on an exercise in the gym for the purpose of a burning fast. We need to wait to keep these animals.
Oh, we can't hear you again. Oh, we lost.
It's no longer possible. Okay. So the president needs to come back to reality. It is not proper for our president to progress in error. Because anybody talking about having a grazing route at a time like this, I need to even ask you a question. Where are the president's children? Where are the children of the ministers? Are they those ones who are just moving with these cattle that are moving in the bush and they stay for a whole month without taking their bath? This is a way of perpetuating the issue of a vicious circle of poverty. It is the children of the poor and those who are not educated that are allowed to be moving with animals. Mm. I hear them talk about freedom of association and freedom of movement. Did our constitution provide freedom of movement for goats and cattle and birds? It provides for freedom of movement for individuals. And nobody is saying that a Fulani man or an Hausa man cannot move to any part of the country. We enjoy their presence here even in Delta. But what we are saying is that you cannot continue to take your cattle, which is not in the constitution, and then graze on other people's farm. And then some persons, because of primordial sentiments, will tell us that freedom of association or freedom of movement guarantees that. But did they guarantee it for cattle? It guarantees it for individuals. And nobody is stopping individuals from moving.
All right.
The other time, the Attorney General of the Constitution, who also I assume is not properly on duty, was talking about the issue of spare parts in the north and comparing it to cattle. And I wonder, can that be coming from our Attorney General and the Minister of Justice? We plead with them to know that this country has been in existence before they came into office, and we would like them to help us preserve this country beyond their tenure of office, because we do want to leave a country that's worked for ourselves and for our
Okay, YK has been laughing since. Thank you very much, former Commissioner for Information at Delta State. It was a very interesting conversation that our leaders must not continue to progress in error. I think that is very instructive. Thank you very much. We're going to go on a break now.
And insightful.
And we come back, YK, you know, because you're 60, we're allowing you.
I can't help it. I'm sorry.
We'll be right back.